And then this one left me confused. I was like, what? I was like, you know what I'm saying? This bro, he's like, yo, she called me daddy and I remembered my absent father, became soft, then eventually went back home, only pain. Unicorn. I've been feeling good, ayy. Hey man, you know what it is? It's your boy, Tana Vukwana, the one and only Mkhosa Wasepitori, Xedi Brafraze Lekopi. And this is episode 14 of Come Kof. This is your show where I wrap up everything that happened during the week. The good, the bad, we laugh, we cry. Anything that happened on the internet this week, trust me, I got you. So without further ado, Come Kof, what happened this week? Issue! Hi, guys. yo, bye. When I say groove. After groove. After groove. It's been a madness, fam. Everybody's been grooving. People are like, do you think I'm gonna eat my youth with a fork and knife? And listen, I get it. Like, I fully get it. I'm just worried about the rents. Like, if you live on your own, please just do what you must. But if you live with your rents, umkhulu, gogo, living in the posi with you, it's tricky. Just be safe in those streets. Cause I would lie, it looked fun. I was watching these snaps. I'm like, yeah, I would lie. Yeah, it's rocking in there, boy. It's rocking. But at the same time, I'm like, ish, me, let me relax. I'm not trying to get the ting, pass it on the ting. Cause I could survive it, but I don't know. You know what I'm saying? But hey. And then I missed all the groove. There was a specific groove which went on after 10 p.m. So of course the khatas are like, yo, we're shutting this down. Ah, I don't know who these kids are, who they are, boy. They said, let me just play the video for you guys. Boy. They were like, no. They were like, yay, you are going out of here. Boy, imagine, how do you get rid of the hot dog? The hotas are coming, they're like the blue boys. We shut this thing down, they're like, no. But in my mind, I'm like, why was the only one hotter there? There should have been way more, you know what I'm saying? Especially, hey guys, hi. And then what also happened, you know what I'm saying? Amongst all the groove, there's a specific like called Junk Park. It's like a restaurant, but it's also like young club nya. So there was a snap of Uncle Vuzi, who's been in, like I've mentioned him on an episode before. He has a YouTube channel called Street Kid, go check it out. So there's a snap of Uncle Vuzi and his boy Slade, you know what I'm saying? Slade is DJing there, Uncle Vuzi, you know what I'm saying? Let me just play the video for you guys. So, you know, the video, it looks like, I don't lie, the vibes are sounding nice. You know what I'm saying? A junk pack. The vibes are looking clean in the video, but Slade was getting a lot of love from the ladies. You know what I'm saying? Like, let me just show you the tweets. Hey, I got some Slade, another one. Then another one. Good night to the Jensen Black and the Jensen Black only. Watch this video just for the men in the North Face shirt. We're all in agreement about the Jensen, the black t-shirt, right? You know what I'm saying? Guys, the boy was getting a lot of love. And then Uncle Bruce was finishing me. He was like, I can see myself walking peacefully. Then all of a sudden, where's your friend in the black? Yo, guys, I was like, homeboy was getting a lot of love. You know what I'm saying? Even though Uncle Fuzzy was there too, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? They were there. You know what I'm saying? Boy, the brutal slate. You know what I'm saying? He was getting a lot of love from the ladies. And then another one she posted, she's like, long story short. You guys know that video where homeboy's like,
straight, baby.
Straight. You know what I'm saying? She said she'd go in on Slade. Then Uncle Fuzzy replies, he's like, they even cropped me out. Yo, it's tough. It's tough, Jets. Yo, like Slade was getting all that love. Like Uncle Vuzi was getting no love, dog. You know what I'm saying? They cropped up, rolled out. It's tough. And then Madlera Dope Boy is a musician. Yeah, one of my favorite musicians. He tweets, he's like, As a part of the friends that always get mice next to our light skin bros association, I will fight for voting like I know him. Oh, and I won't lie, gents, guys, hey, me, I felt this. I was like, yeah, I get it. Like this one, me, I know the pain. Like, I know, you see, Uncle Fuzi, when they said crop, you know what I'm saying? What my dad is saying is like, on behalf of the niggas who get mice next to your light skin bro, my boy, I'm telling, let me tell you now, it happened to me now. It's been happening my whole life, you know what I'm saying? When you're just that broad, they be like, yo, Tunde, you're so funny. Who's your friend? Nigga, who's my... Nigga, I'm here, dog. Like, fuck with me, dog. Rock with your boy. Funny enough, my latest video that I posted with me, NJ, and us and my boys, I posted on my WhatsApp status, someone sends me this message. Fuck. You see what I'm saying? You know, I'm out here with a fresh cut, dog. Like, I'll be doing the most. Like, look at me. Like, you know what I'm saying? I got a clean card today, but I know at the end of the day, it's just gonna be Tunde, you're funny, never Tunde, you're cute. But nah, I'm just joking, but it is what it is, yo. And then what also happened this week, someone tweeted asking people, yo, what's been your worst sexual experience? And that tweet got a lot of traction and a lot of people, guys, the tweet I read, a lot of people had a lot of interesting stories. Let me read you a few here. From the jump, I couldn't feel it. It was like I was being tickled, so I started scrolling through my phone. I was so defeated.
Guys,
what is going on? Another one. He peed on me. He said he didn't know it was pee. He thought it was cum. I was so humiliated. Yeah? Then another one I saw that had moon three different names, and mine wasn't one of. By the first one, surely you're leaving. After, you know, next thing you're there, you're too mellow, you know what I'm saying? All you hear, George, you. She could be an okay wasabi stan, you know what I'm saying? Watching a YouTube video earlier. Now, George, are you like, George who? Now she says, George, Alex, Bob. You're like, you didn't leave after one, after two, only three. But what do I know? Me, I know none of these things. I'm just reading, you know what I'm saying? And then this one also finished me. She's like, he hit it from the back, Watula Langomo, Old Town Road. So if you don't understand what it means, she says, your homeboy hit it from the back and he started singing that song. I'm gonna sing. I'm gonna ride till I can't no more. And then this one left me confused. I was like, what? I was like, you know what I'm saying? This brute, he's like, yo, she called me daddy and I remembered my absent father. Became soft, then eventually went back home, only pain. I don't know, do I love? Or do I know? It's a very tricky one, guys. Yeah, then there was this one. I was wasted and I vomited mid giving head. Guys, me, I know none of these things, but just reading and like picturing what you guys are saying. You guys do a lot, like I thought. And then there was this one, I was like, no, hold up. So this bro tweet is like, she had a seizure milk stroke. I'm like, whoa, that sounds very serious. Like, I'm sure it was seen, that wasn't even funny now. It was just hectic. And then I come across another tweet, I'm like, no, what a no. This hand, she tweets, she's like, I faked a seizure during sex because I wanted him to stop. He just wasn't doing it for me. I'm like, homeboy said he was the girl who had a seizure. This one is saying she faked. Wait, I don't know where that bro is, who he is, but I'm sure it was pain. When he saw, I don't know if they even follow each other, but if he came across that tweet after he, I can only imagine the pain, bro. And then what also happened this week, you know, it was just really disheartening and very sad, you know what I'm saying? Like, very, it's actually, yo, it's angry, like, it makes you angry to think, like, how can one person be so sick and just so evil? Like, if you guys don't know, let me tell you what happened. Nathaniel Julius, a 16-year-old from El Dorado Park, Gauteng, has been shot dead by police. Nathaniel, who had Down syndrome, bought biscuits at a nearby tech shop, and while eating the biscuits and sitting with friends, a police van approached the group. The police asked Nathaniel what was going on, and due to his condition, he was unable to speak clearly. Nathaniel was then shot by a police officer, thrown in the back of the van, and taken to the hospital where he passed away. And it just makes you think, like, how do you... He was not armed, didn't attack the police. You know what I'm saying? But yet he has to die. And this is not something like that's far in America. You know what I'm saying? Because these are a lot of the type of stories you know. This is like right here, South Africa, here at home. You know what I'm saying? Someone, one of our own people just died. A kid, innocent, did nothing wrong. A policeman was just like, yo, let me shoot this guy. And amidst everything that's been going on, you know, all the gender-based violence, and it's like, it just goes to show, like, the people who are even supposed to protect you don't do that. Like, who do we look to? Who do we turn to? And there was a lot of, you know, like, there was a lot of outrage on Twitter and, you know, and in the community of El Dorado Park, you know what I'm saying? People were protesting, fighting against the police, rightfully so. But then on Twitter, there was, you know, a different type of battle which didn't sit too right with me. And I wanted to address it. Because what happened was, you know, I won't look for the tweets and what, but like generally, a lot of people were like, yo, a lot of people, certain, not everyone, just certain individuals are like, yo, dude, coloreds are anti-black. And, you know, certain coloreds, they were like, yo, black people don't care for us, South Africans don't care for us. And for me, I'm just like, it baffles me how we're so fixated on black, putting black people and colored people against each other. When that's not even the issue here. The issue is the police. You know what I'm saying? Because when black people and colored people are fighting over the most dumbest of things, no one wins in the end. The white man smiles and no justice prevails. You get me? So like, I just found all that pointless. I didn't even want to like look for tweets and show you because it's just dumb, dude. Like, how you so fixated on such when an innocent kid just died? I'ma leave, as usual, I'ma leave petitions to sign in the bio, in the description below to help with the situation and to get it light, because especially in South Africa, not a lot of things get shed light on in the governments, in the parliaments, you know what I'm saying? Our presidents, our governments move and operate in silence, like they don't have Twitter, like they don't see what's going on. And then lastly, you know what I'm saying, on this week's segment of Come Up This Plug, quite a lot of drops are gonna happen this week and have happened. By the time you see this, all the drops I'm about to speak about have already happened. So Apollo the Mortal, I'm saying, he dropped his debut EP, 13 tracks, titled 19 for Once. I messed with the song Collect, it's a vibe. You guys should go check it out. And then Jodacosi, guys, I promise you guys, please, you guys must come back to this video when she blows. I told you guys last week about her. I'm telling you about it again. Her song Truth is dropped today. Yes, today. It's out. Friday, right now. I'm going to put the links in the description. Trust me, for all the R&B, I'm going to probably even use it at the end of the video. So make sure you go grab that. I'm going to put the link in the description. And I'm saying, probably nobody doesn't know this, but I'm going to just put it in. Nasty C dropped his album, Zuluman on Some Power. A lot of bangers already released. He got a lot of international features from Lil Key to Lil Gotti, you know what I'm saying, to Ari Lennox. I'm really excited to hear this. By the time you guys are watching this, it's probably out everywhere. Like, just go run it up. I'm sure it's a fire album. I'm gonna come back to it next week. That's all the plugs for this week, and make sure you go grab them. And yeah, you know, that brings me to the end of this week's episode of Come Up. I thank you guys for watching. Please say subscribe, you know what I'm saying? Say the notification bell. Also say, you know what I'm saying, follow me on the socials, you know what I'm saying? And I hope to see you guys again next week. Make sure you come back on Monday. Yes, I post every Monday now. So I post every Friday and Monday. Come Up on the Fridays and Mondays, it's a surprise. Whether it's a sit down, it's a vlog, it's a what's not. Make sure you guys go check it out. I love you guys. It's been your boy, Tanda Vogon, AK6 Unicorn, the one and only Mkhosa Wasepi Tori, Excedi, Bra, Fraja, Lekapi. And come talk what happens next week. Isho! I love you. Even begged you to choose me. Had your chance and you blew it. Don't hit me up, we've been through this. Truth is, I loved you. Truth is, I loved you. Even begged you to choose me. Truth is, I loved you. Even begged you to choose me. I shouldn't have to call to convince you to come. Choo! Utla! In my dreams, Alexander.
trying to forget.
Come on, what you say? The bounce on the song go crazy, and the lyrics. Listen, I was trying to forget,
but I was always focused. I never called my name. I used to walk to work every day. Me and my dog, and I came out alright.
You were young and in this world, chasing dreams and girls, running from my problems. And now we're older now. Let's city 1, 2, 3. I remember we were young. We young and dumb. Rock. Come on, Brent Faizi. Brent Faizi in the busy. I am sexy, unicorn, too easy. It's too easy, my drip's too much, too sneezy. Coming with the freestyle, man, come love me. This has got that drink, you know what I'm saying?
All the homies, we can move the same way. And I swear, no change.
Hey, what you say? You guys remember what I said to this world?
We were young and in this world, chasing dreams and girls, running from my problems.
And I know we're older now, young and dumb. It's the gang over love. It's the gang. It's the gang. Oh, it's the gang over love. 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 Let's go. The show come to next.
Remember
week.
We were cut.